in baseball. In the 90s, steroid use was a humongous thing. And the NFL has started cracking down now with these humongous suspensions by Roger Goodell, suspending 4 games, 6 games, humongous fines.
Big scandals is the Flipgate, where 11 out of 12 footballs in the AFC Championship. What are your thoughts on it?
I think that is not, that's something that the Patriots have been getting away for years. Like, for example, the Spygate back in the day, Robert Kraft kind of got away with that because I think he's buddy-buddy with Roger Goodell, and I don't think that was right of them. I think Spygate should have had more of an action, and I think Roger Goodell is not going to miss his point this time. I think he's going to give a harsh suspension this time.
Every team, everything does that, but to actually do it for practically.
This also kind of changed the rule of that teams are allowed to bring their own, regulate their own footballs into the circulation instead of letting the home team have their circulation balls going with the other team.
Unless, of course, talk about the car. During the NBA Finals, the Spurs Heat game, where the team went. That was intentional.
Well, I think it was. I mean, I didn't think it was anything that big. I didn't really. I mean, the AC.
From California.
Downer when it comes to this, but I think cheating in sports is kind of a necessary evil. Every professional sports league is full of thousands of athletes that are almost on the same tier with each other, who actually get real life bonuses for winning. So I'm just gonna leave it with, like, if you ain't cheating, you ain't trying. I think there's cheating in every aspect of every sport. The dumber people get caught. The people that know what they're doing don't.
Yeah, I mean, everyone knows that. Have been cheating as about the or any not the other body that could have affected the outcome even more than the Patriots.